The beauty of the repeat sales index methodology lies in its simplicity. In this tutorial, we explain the concept behind the methodology, and through different ways, we will construct a simple index using the two standard approaches. In 1963, Bailey, Muth and Nourse developed the methodology for constructing a real estate index. The idea was simple. The coefficients of the index at each designated period can be estimated by running an ordinary least square regression. The log price difference is regressed on time dummy variables that take the value of -1 in the period of the first sale, +1 in the period of the second sale, and 0 otherwise. Alternatively, as we will see later, the dummy values can be treated differently. Let us start with an example. Consider the case of three houses that were repeatedly sold between 2013 and 2015. We have sales in 3 years, and we want to observe the index level at each of them. The index should measure percentage changes in value. That is, the percentage change in index value should be equivalent to the percentage change in the values of houses. Thus, the index must satisfy the following system of equations. The ratio of the index level in the second sales year to the first is equal to the ratio of the second sales price to the first. To normalize the repeated sale index, we set the index of the base year, which is 2013 and is our case, to 1. This simplifies our equations to the following. We have three equations of two unknowns. We can simply get the best estimates for the unknown values by running a linear regression. We linearize the system by taking the logs at each side. Let us denote the log of the index by beta, the standard regression coefficient symbol. Using matrix notation, we can rewrite the three equations into one. We can clearly note that the independent matrix is not but the yearly dummy variables. Let us write them down. In the year of first sale, the dummy value is -1. In the year of the second sale, it is +1. Otherwise, it is 0. We don't need the variables for the base year as we set the index to 1, which means that the log index is 0. We end up with the same set of variables following this simple approach. In order to estimate the index, we only need the prices at different periods. Using an OLS procedure, we can estimate the coefficients in our example. The coefficients column vector is equal to the inverse of the product of the transpose dummies matrix by its own multiplied by the transpose and the column vector of log returns. That is, the log index values in 2014 and 2015 are 0.07 and 0.15 respectively. To calculate the index levels, we calculate the exponents or anti-log of these values. We can check these results in Excel. We have the initial table. All we need is to create a table consisting of the log price changes and time dummy variables. We set the dummy value to -1 in the year of first sale, +1 in the year of second sale and 0 otherwise. Then, we select the Data tab, and choose Data Analysis. In the menu, we select Regression. We define Y values as the log price difference. We choose the X values as the dummy matrix of the last 2 years, as we set the coefficient of the base year, 2013, to 0. We tick labels as the table has headers, and choose the constant to be 0. We define the output range, and click OK. The coefficients are the same as per the manual calculations. You could alternatively type to the regression equation manually to get the output. Before we finish, let us look at another approach. Note that you could treat the dummy variables differently. Instead of assigning minus ones and plus ones, you just assign one for the periods after the first sale until the second sale, and zero otherwise. This way, we observe the index value relative to the previous year and not the base. Let's copy the current sheet to illustrate on this approach. For the first house, the first sale was in 2013, and the second in 2015. Thus, we assign 0 for the first year, and 1s for 2014 and 2015. We apply the same to the other units. We can notice the results without running the regression since we used the formulas. The figure is identical in the first year, because in either case, the log price change is compared with 2013. The coefficient for 2015, however, is different. This is due to the fact that following this approach, we look at the relative price change. Meaning that, unlike in the first approach where we look at the price change relative to the base year, we observe the price change relative to the previous year. That is, if we add the coefficients of 2014 and 2015, we get the relative change in 2015 compared to the base year. The total is the value of the index in 2015 following the first approach. That is all for this tutorial. If you like to see how we construct the index with large data sets, you can refer to the other tutorial. Additionally, if you are interested in understanding the Case-Shiller 3 steps index, you can refer to the link in the description of this video. That is all for this tutorial. I hope it was useful to you.